Press the bell icon on YouTube and don't miss another update.
There are three good reasons why I'm not talking about the budget today, but talking instead about the crash of a Mirage 2000 of Indian Air Force. The reason I don't talk about the budget, one, because I think you've already overdosed on it. Everybody's talking about it. Second, I'm not an economist, so it's not for me to crunch the budget numbers. Let people with the right skills do it. And you may have seen Ila Patnaik do it in Ilanomics. If you haven't, please watch Ilanomics on our YouTube channel. And three, because something else happened today, and I don't want, and you don't want, that story to get lost in the noise of the budget. And that is the crash of a Mirage 2000 in Bangalore. Now, a newly refurbished Mirage crashed as it took off. Unfortunately, it took down with it both experienced, expert IAF pilots, both of whom unfortunately died. This is a very big loss. Now, what is the clutter behind this loss? The clutter, because after all, fighter flying is a dangerous profession. Fighter planes crash, unfortunately people die, it's part of life. But no, there is a great deal of clutter in this story, which I am trying to break for you, or cut for you. This was a newly refurbished Mirage 2000. Now, let me tell you something about Mirage 2000s. For about 30 years, Mirage 2000 has been the most reliable aircraft of the Indian Air Force. We've had very few of these. Initially, only two squadrons were bought. Mrs. Gandhi, Indira Gandhi ordered these. The first aircraft came in Rajiv Gandhi's times. The first squadron was raised in Gwalior. That is where the second squadron was also raised. And now there are three squadrons. In fact, Indian Air Force loved this plane so much that in the course of time, they wanted more of these. So more were bought from Dassault, and India built three squadrons. All three squadrons, there is no secret about it, in peacetime are based in Gwalior, which is the home of Mirage 2000s. These squadrons are 1, Tigers, 2, Battle Axes, and 3, nine Wolfpack. So, squadron 1, 7, 9, 3 of the most celebrated squadrons of Indian Air Force fly quite proudly the Mirage 2000. You remember in Kargil, after several days of operations by Indian Air Force, when a couple of aircraft, in fact 3 aircraft were lost, a MiG-27, a MiG-21 bis, and also a Mi-17, and a Canberra, photo reconnaissance Canberra was hit. Indian Air Force decided to bring in its best weapon. That was the Mirage 2000. And you've seen those pictures of Mirage 2000 dropping those laser guided bombs onto Pakistani battlements and Pakistani fortifications and destroying them. And that made a decisive difference to the war even in 1999. Until now, even now, this is the most efficient, the most serviceable, the most trusted aircraft in the inventory of the IAF. That's why IAF decided that while they would buy more modern aircraft, they would extend the life of this aircraft by ordering a new refit, a modernization, refit, making them fully nuclear capable, putting new radars, new avionics, and also new long-range missiles on these. So this agreement was signed with Dassault. Remember, Dassault is the same company that makes Rafale. So it was a $2 billion plus, almost a $3 billion contract that was signed with Dassault to upgrade 51 Mirages that Indian Air Force had at that point. Now, two of these unfortunately were lost in quick succession in crashes. So there were 49 left. Of the 49, 2 were to be refurbished and modernized by or retrofitted by Dassault itself. The rest was to be done in India by HAL. So that was $2.2 billion contract that was given to the HAL. And you've seen HAL come up in all our discussions about manufacturing the Rafale. Now, HAL should have finished this job by now. definitely in 2019. It is already more than 3 years late on this project. It has so far only given 7 refurbished, modernized Mirage 2000s back to the Air Force. What crashed today was the 8th. Now, first of all, the delay in the process. Second, the crash of a brand new aircraft as it takes off. Today's flight was not about checking out what's being done to the aircraft. Today's flight was called an acceptance flight. It's a formality. What that means is the manufacturer says, look, I've tested this plane. I've done whatever I had to do with it. All manufacturers have great test pilots. In fact, some of the finest test pilots of Indian Air Force work with HAL. I've met those people. They are as good as any in the world, if not better. So they had flown this aircraft. HAL had certified this aircraft as being fit for delivery. These two Indian Air Force pilots had just come for a customer's acceptance trial, which is I take off in the aircraft. It's a formality. And what happened? As they took off, something happened. We don't exactly know what has happened, but the aircraft crashed. Both pilots could not eject safely. Although this is a very modern aircraft with 00 ejection seats. 00 means an aircraft from where you can even eject when the aircraft is stationary on the ground. So your ejection seat will go high up and parachute will open and you will come down. But that obviously happened because there was no time at takeoff, because that's when the aircraft is drawing the fullest power from its engines and pilots are busy. So we lost one of our very few Mirages, only 3 squadrons, and 2 of our finest fighter pilots. It raises many questions. One, should a plane which has just been refurbished, has gone through testing, be so fragile as to crash on its first takeoff by its users? Second, it also brings our attention to the delays and the expense in the process of refurbishment of these aircraft, these Dassault-made aircraft at HAL. Because remember, when UPA was considering manufacturing Rafales at HAL, there were doubts expressed by both Indian Air Force and by Dassault. Because Indian Air Force wanted performance guarantees on these aircraft, Dassault said that they cannot stand guarantee for anything manufactured at HAL. Now, our nationalist sentiment would immediately say, oh, this is our government's company, how dare you do it? But the fact is that they are the manufacturers. They have to stand guarantee. So, if HAL said they will stand guarantee, but that wasn't good enough. Until Dassault stands guarantee, Indian Air Force would not accept it. Now, this brings our attention to HAL's record, not just for manufacturing aircraft, which is actually zilch, manufacturing anything original despite all talk of technology transfer, but it also tells you a story of delays, cost overruns, and really workmanship. HAL has fantastic talent. It has great talented people. It has a pool of great engineers, scientists. It works very closely with DRDO's aeronautical labs, but it does seem to suffer from the problems that would affect any monopoly, especially a PSU monopoly, because this is ultimately a department of the government. So, this sad loss today once again reminds us of this. It reminds us of the need of expanding Make in India. It reminds us of the need of getting the best of Indian manufacturing, best of Indian technologies into armament manufacturing, breaking the monopolies, even if they happen to be government monopolies, not breaking them as in shutting them down, but challenging them with competition, because lack of competition makes everybody lazy. And the last thing you want happening because of that laziness is for your company to suffer the loss of such valuable lives and such expensive equipment. In fact, lives enormously more expensive, more invaluable than the equipment. So, obviously, argument is not that you can pick it all up and give it to a corporate that you love. It may be one Ambani or one whoever. That is not the argument. The argument is India is now a big engineering manufacturing power. Leverage that power. Don't get caught up in this PSU versus private sector business, because this monopoly, HAL, has not served. It's a great company, but it's a great company with just about just over $2 billion turnover as a monopoly, which is nothing, really very poor. So it's a great company with a great potential. It needs competition because competition will bring out greater excellence and greater efficiencies. So this loss today, again, a very expensive loss, but also a lesson. And if it does wake us up, and if it does wake up the public opinion where HAL has now been deified, I think Indian Air Force will be grateful in the course of time.